Thank you very much. Hello, everyone. Thank you for being here. My name is Karim Bagaria, and I am a third year PhD student, actually fourth year. I started as fourth year in computer science. And I work with Professor Helger Lippmann that mostly has been working for a long time on zero-knowledge proofs and mostly non-interactive zero-knowledge proofs. Here I have listed the topics that I have studied and I have, done some research. Mostly they are around zero-knowledge proofs, but since I have some background in electrical engineering, so I have been also interested to some applications of ZK-SNOGs. SNOGs are the particular and very known family of non-interactive zero-knowledge proofs that are appeared in various applications, including Pinocchio for verifiable computation and some privacy-preserving applications like as Zcash, Hawk, and recently proposed private proof of stake called Ouroboros CubeSinus. And I also, in this case, we will later discuss that the best problem I could say that is the trust issue that we have to the third parties. So I have been doing some research to relaxing and reducing trust in that case. So my presentation today mostly is related to some applications like as privacy preserving smart contracts and also reducing trust in non-interactive zero-knowledge proofs. Basically, this presentation would be in two parts. That first part, I will talk about how to reduce trust to the third party in the CRS model. And in the second part, I will talk about constructing more efficient UC secure ZK SNOGs that are appeared in some UC secure applications like as Hawk for smart contracts. These are some publications that I had related to this topic, but today I will mostly cover the first result that is published in AsiaCrypt 2017 and was one of top three papers, which is invited to Journal of Cryptography. And second, that was published recently in AfricaCrypt that I just showed that we can construct more efficient ZK SNOGs than that they have used in their system. Just as an introduction, I will start with interactive argument or proof systems. Usually in different applications, we need to give a proof or a statement to show that we have this statement has some property. For example, you want to give a proof that you are a doctor and you want to show that you know a particular secret key for some non-public key. You can, usually these proofs are done in interactive case that are called Sigma protocols. And if I want to make it more efficient, more formal, usually they called Sigma protocols by three messages, and the first one is commit, that prover sends some commitment for some random values and then gets some challenges, and then based on this commit and challenge introduces the last message that is called response. And this communication between this prover and verifier that are called proof. In real life, usually this interaction is not easy because maybe the verifier, is not online, so we usually are interested to non-interactive cases. And to construct such non-interactive systems, we have two models that are quite known. The first one is in the random oracle model, and based on Fiat-Shamir transformation, they proposes that instead of getting challenge from verifier side, you easily can, apply some random function to instantiate this random oracle and get to this second message. Basically, you can prover can send these three messages together, and we don't need to have verifier online. And the second model is a CRS model, which in this case, we need to have a trusted party to generate the common reference string. And basically, you can call it some public parameters that later will be used by prover and verifier to proof generation and proof verification. If I want to be a little bit more formalized, we have a third party that runs some algorithm, known algorithm called CRS generation, and takes some information about the relation that you want to generate public parameters and generates common reference string. For example, Zcash has used some MPC protocol to generate this public parameter that will be used in proof generation and proof verification when you want to spend a coin. And in such system, usually we expect to guarantee some security properties. That the first and the very basic one is the completeness. We expect that if both prover and verifier are honest, so the system should work and we should be able to convince the verifier that the statement is valid. So the second one is soundness. We usually expect that if the prover is dishonest, lying, so he shouldn't be able to convince me. This property is called soundness. But basically we say that this honest prover will not come with honest verifier. And in some applications, this soundness is not enough, so we need a slightly stronger notion that is called knowledge soundness. And this is important in the case that we want to get sure that prover knows this witness, not only has it. The difference between knowing and having, you can compare in your smart cards. You have smart cards you use for your credit cards, for example. You just insert a four-digit password and you, I mean, unlock your secret key, but you never know your secret key. In that case, you have it, but you don't know it. But in some proof systems, basically in proof of knowledge systems, we require that the system should guarantee that the prover actually knows it, not only does, I mean, has it. But in real life, we also require that the proofs that we have generated and guaranteed this knowledge soundness should be non-malleable, such that no one can does, I mean, man-in-the-middle attack on them and give a new proof based on old proofs. Basically, this property that we have in signature, that they should be unforgeable. After seeing several signatures, you shouldn't be able to generate a new one. And here we say that after seeing several proofs, simulated proof, you shouldn't be able to generate a new proof. The third property is called zero knowledge, which is very important to guarantee the privacy of prover. And we usually say that dishonest verifier only gets to know that the statement is true, nothing, I mean, more about the witness that you have used. Prover uses witness to give a proof for a statement, and verifier shouldn't learn anything about this witness. And how in the protocols we formalize this concept by showing that there is another, algorithm, we call it simulator, that without getting these witnesses, but gets the trapdoors of this common reference string, some secret information about the setup phase, can produce a proof which is indistinguishable from the proof that prover has generated by witnesses. Basically, it shows that it gives a guarantee that prover, you don't need to worry. Why? Because your proof doesn't depend on witness. Basically, I can produce something which is indistinguishable from yours without even knowing your witnesses. This is sort of guaranteeing the privacy of sender. And when we want to prove that a protocol is zero knowledge, so we need to construct this algorithm simulator. For different protocols, we will have different simulators. But basically, all of them want to show that we can simulate your proofs. So this is important that I wanted to emphasize, because later we will focus on constructing simulator for some subversion secure protocols. And in real life, we are very interested to make these arguments succinct as much as possible. So this is the case in the SNARKs as well. We want to make very short proofs such that, very weak client can verify it very quickly, very fast. This is very good actually for nodes, also for blockchain applications, because easily they can verify proof in milliseconds. This all together gathered in ZK SNARKs that the protocol should be succinct. The proof should be succinct, very short. It should guarantee zero knowledge because of prover. Verifier shouldn't learn anything about prover. And it should be argument of knowledge. That argument of knowledge actually is equivalent to this knowledge soundness, the second one. So basically, by default, SNARKs doesn't guarantee non-malleability. So this is one issue that if you want to use in real life, so you should guarantee, by some other tools like signatures, you provide this non-malleability of proofs. And also they are non-interactive, that are very useful, that you don't need to have interaction. And by now, there have been, from 2010, initiated by Grot, they have been various constructions for ZK SNARKs. One very known one is Pinocchio, which is proposed by Microsoft for verifiable computations. And it has various compilers that later we will see. And currently, the most efficient one is Grot from 2006 from Eurocube. But its proofs are non-malleable. In 2017, Grot and Muller in crypto, they gave a new construction that guarantees non-malleability of proofs as well. But it is not as efficient as Grot. So recently, in Shahla's thesis, we got interested to present a new version of this Grot, which guarantees the non-malleability of proofs, but it is better than Grot and Muller. That was currently the only available SNARK that guarantees non-malleability. And recently my supervisor also presented some constructions that still are in eprint. Due to this very nice properties that ZK-SNARKs, particularly SNARKs proposed, so they have appeared in various applications because they can guarantee honestly. We will see that how they can, for example, where it is important. And they can also keep the, maintain the privacy of the prover. So they have appeared in verifiable computations, Zcash as a privacy preserving coin, and digital signatures, and e-voting, and privacy preserving smart contracts, and recently proof of stake, private proof of stake. But in all of them, something is in common, and this is just computation. And we will see that, for example, for verifiable computation, usually in verifiable computation, you have a function with some input. Maybe it has two inputs, one from prover and one from your side. But for a basic case, for example, it's from your side. You want to outsource it and get a proof that, get a function that evaluated this function in this X, this input. But you need a proof from prover side because you don't trust the prover that this was done correctly. Actually, Pinocchio was the first system that developed all encoders and all compilers for such system. I mean, you as a developer write a C++ code and it converts it, it has a particular compiler, it converts it to the arithmetic circuit, and later they have encoder, it converts it to the quadratic arithmetic program, which SNARKs works with that one. So if in your real life, in your application, you want to use ZK-SNARKs for privacy preserving application, so you need to construct this cap. Some people are expert and they directly introduce or, construct arithmetic circuit, but some people are not and just developers, so they write this C code and just use compiler of Microsoft to convert it to circuit and later convert it to cap and then use SNARKs. All of SNARKs can be used, but you see that some people saw that, for example, Zcash moved to new SNARKs because it is faster than. Basically, they changed this last block. So this was a short, actually very quick summary to drainage proofs and non-interactive cases and CRS model and SNARKs that are particular case of NISCs in CRS model. And I just mentioned to some applications. But one big problem about SNARKs is this last item that I have written here, require a trusted setup. I mean, everything is fine. It's very nice in proof generation, sort of, and its proofs are very succinct, you can verify them, and verifier is happy because you can just in milliseconds check the proof. But there is this trust problem that you need to trust to some third party. So one motivation for my research was how we can decrease this trust. And we, since in 2017, the best one actually currently also, the best one is this, Graz SNARK from 2016, so we focused on that one, but let me give you just very quick overview on Graz SNARK. So currently it works for CAPS. CAPS means quadratic arithmetic program. That basically it means that the arithmetic circuit that you want to give a proof only has multiplication and addition gates. This Graz-Miller is inefficient because it is constructed for SAPS, square arithmetic program. The circuits that only has squaring and addition. And usually for multiplication gate, you need two squaring gates, a minus b square minus a plus b square divided by 4. So it needs two squaring gates. So this is the reason that why Graz-Miller is not efficient. So we try to give a new SNARK which works based on CAPS, not SAPS. We will see an implementation. Actually, Shahla will present it. So this is the most efficient one. So we started to think about this trusted party. What this trusted party generates? We already mentioned that to proving the zero knowledge, we need to construct simulator, which meets these trapdoors of CRS. And also it generates the CRS, which are given to prover and verifier to proof generation and to proof verification. So one can easily ask that what if this subverter, I will call this malicious CRS generator subverter. What if this subverter cooperates with prover? We said that prover shouldn't be able to convince the verifier if he really doesn't know the witness, for example. But if they, cooperate with each other, so easily you can break the soundness. Why? Because this simulator actually says that if you have zero knowledge, you have a simulator that without knowing the witness can generate a proof. Basically, you can use that simulator to break the proof. So in real life, if you want to achieve subversion security about soundness, so we need a system that remains sound even if the subverter, I mean, this CRS generator, cooperates with the prover. But they shouldn't be able to even, I mean, now in this case, is to give a proof. And the second case is that in the case that this third party, I mean, cooperates with verifier. So what if these two collaborate together to break the zero knowledge? For example, to learn more than what they had actually supposed to learn about the witness. So, and if they cooperate each other, so we, in proving zero knowledge, we use these trapdoors, TD. So if they cooperate, so we cannot trust it anymore. These two challenges were that we had. But in 2016, Bellar et al. Studied security of non-interactive zero knowledge proofs in case of, I mean, subverting CRS. They showed that these together are not possible. And I mentioned that why? Because when you have zero knowledge, you have a simulator that without, I mean, witnesses, just with trapdoors can generate a fake proof. So if you want to don't trust to a third party, easily this zero knowledge property gives you adversary, gives you a construction for an adversary that can break this soundness. Why? Because without knowing the witness, he could give a proof. But in soundness, we say that you shouldn't be able to give a proof without knowing the witness. So these are contradictions. So you can, these definitions are not complete. So DA showed that this is impossible. So we focused in the second one. I mean, we focused in the constructing a system that without trusting the third party, they can't guarantee the zero knowledge, I mean, in the protocol. Prover doesn't need, basically, to trust. So if they two cooperate, so it means that trapdoors are not trusted anymore, and this CRS might not be safe. For example, when you use CRS to generate a proof, you multiply some randomnesses to some elements from CRS. So if these elements are not generated correctly, for example, they are zero, they easily can cancel out your randomness from the proof. So this is not safe. So basically, we have two problems. The first one is that we need to guarantee the correctness of CRS trapdoors. Since we have not trusted to the third party, so how we should get sure that they are correct? And the second one is this safety of the CRS. We should get, I mean, sure that these CRS elements are safe. Prover should actually be happy that to use them. So, for first problem, we proposed, I mean, not we actually, Bellar et al. Used for different constructions, but we constructed for this construction, how to extract the CRS. But the idea is to use some non-black box extraction algorithm to extract the trapdoors from this subverter. We will see how, for example, this is possible. And for doing that one, we have some knowledge assumption extractors that you might have heard about them, that, for example, if an adversary given G, the generator of a group, can produce these three elements, G power X and G power X square, so basically he knows the X. This is some kind of heuristic X assumption. I mean, we call them non-falsifiable assumption, not a standard, but it states that it knows, and this knowing is formalized by showing that there exists an extraction algorithm that can extract this X from this adversary, given access to the source code of adversary. This is important, and also random coins. This is basically non-black box extraction. So we can use such non-black box extraction. I mean, simulator can use that one. And to do that, I mean, we enforce subverter to put some elements, for example, in that form. Some of trapdoors that we need for simulation, they should be published in that three forms. For example, this is one knowledge assumption. Another knowledge assumption says that if for a symmetric bilinear, for example, group, if adversary can produce X in both groups, basically he knows it. In our case, I mean, for Grad case, we actually use that knowledge assumption, but this is different knowledge assumption. So you enforce subverter, this CRS generator, to put trapdoors in both groups. Basically, with that one, you can extract. But you should be careful. Why? Because when you're changing the CRS element, you also need to care about be careful about the proof of soundness, because if you give more information in the CRS, you might actually lose your proof that you had. So you need to check the proof again and redo the proof, and to guarantee that both are now kept. The first problem was solved. So for the second problem, we needed to get sure that this CRS is safe. So basically, we can just provide an algorithm for prover. That prover just uses that an algorithm to check that this CRS elements are well formed, we call them. And we have actually proposed a CRS verification algorithm for grads, for example, ZK-SNAP. Basically, with that one, I mean, with this CRS verification, when CRS is generated by a subverter, so prover will not use it before checking it. It sends it to the CRS verification algorithm, and if it gets accepted, so it generates a proof and go ahead, I mean, continues by this one. This property will actually guarantee that, I mean, this CRS is safe. And this CV algorithm, later we will see that we have implemented this. It does the same that prover does, I mean, just some pairings, not so super power actually. And we need only, I mean, we as a prover only need to check this CRS once. For example, you are a node in Zcash, but you need to give proof several times with the same CRS. So you only need to check it once. Later, you don't need to check it, because you just need to check that this is the same CRS. And for prover, it's important that this running time of CV is not so big, so it's quite close to the prover. So basically, we solved these both problems by that two solutions. One by extracting trapdoors from CRS generator, one by checking CRS elements by some efficient algorithm. So now we have the correct trapdoors that we wanted. We didn't get it directly, we extracted ourselves. And we have checked the CRS elements about the safeness of these elements. So basically we can simulate now. Why? Because simulator just needed these trapdoors and just it. So now we have it, we can simulate. So still zero knowledge is provided without trusting to the third party. But what we did in summary, just to highlight, we had GRUT with three algorithms, CRS generator, prover, and verifier. So we slightly changed their CRS, I mean GRUT CRS, and we proposed a new CRS verify algorithm that before using CRS, basically uses, I mean, this algorithm to check the CRS elements. We have implemented actually this protocol, the variation that we proposed in LibSnark, which is currently the best library and very known actually for SNARKs. And here is the performance of our system, that we needed to have close efficiency to prover, that you can see that for different arithmetic circuits with different number of gates, I mean, we will have a longer, if you have big circuits, so you will have a longer CRS, so you need to spend more time to check the CRS. So basically, but you see that in bigger circuits, even CRS verification is faster than prover running time. So you can run in parallel, and if both are okay, so you can generate a proof. And we have used, I should mention that we have used batching techniques to make it very efficient. We had a standard form, but it was not efficient. And CRS has extended, I mean, is extended about 30% with this assumption that we use. Later, actually, we observed that it is possible to, without extending, even but using different knowledge assumptions, to do the same.
So how big is CRS?
And usually, based on circuit size, for example, 400 megabytes, 200 megabytes. It depends on your circuit.
It depends on the circuit. Yes. It depends on the circuit. Maximum circuit size.
Zcash had a circuit already about 4 million gates, and they had around 1 gigabyte CRS size. So if we look at to the problem from trust point of view, we already had a CRS, we already had a ZK-SNARK, that both prover and verifier needed to trust one party. But we showed that prover now doesn't need to trust. So one, I mean, step, next step could be, can we reduce trust in the setup phase even more? This question actually can be answered positively by combining MPC and this subversion zero knowledge that we achieved. Luckily, I mean, in 2015, Zcash team, Bensasson et al, they constructed a particular MPC protocol and very efficient for generating CRS of ZK snarks, but they didn't discuss this subversion zero knowledge. So if we combine it, so basically instead of this one, we will have that one. That prover doesn't need to trust anyone, but verifier needs to trust only one of these M parties that are involved in this MPC protocol. So a natural question here is that, can we achieve that one? I mean, also verifier doesn't need to trust anyone. And this is shown that it is impossible because Bellar et al. Showed that we need trusted party to have soundness and zero knowledge. But what if we look at the problem from a different perspective? So verifier needed to one party to be, I mean, honest. So what if this verifier is that one party? This is the key idea behind updatable snarks that are proposed in 2018 by Jens Grote and his team in crypto, that we will have parameters that are updatable. Verifier doesn't need to trust anyone. Okay, basically he just needs to take them and update once, and now he's guaranteed that the protocol, I mean, will be safe and the parameters are generated honestly. Basically, it says that verifier can join to this MPC protocol whenever he likes. Something like this would be this updating. We have G power X1. Next party gets this G power X1 and X2. I mean, generates this G power X1, X2, gives a proof by just pairing that, by linear pairing that this I know this X2. And you check the well-formedness, I mean, this correctness of update. And now verifier doesn't need to trust anyone. And it is universal. I didn't hear mentioned about it, but snarks had one problem that if you change the circuit that you want to give a proof, so you need to generate a new CRS. And this is a problem in applications like as Hawk. Why? Because they have different smart contracts, so they need different circuit, now new CRS. For each smart contract, they needed to generate a new CRS. But with this property, universality, so you can easily, I mean, use the same string for different smart contracts. You can just use this universal parameter and generate it, customize it for that particular smart contract. Yeah, this was actually a presentation of this first part. But recently, I mean, I already mentioned that Grot scheme doesn't guarantee the non-malleability of proofs. So we show that prover doesn't need to trust, but verifier needs to trust. By verifier, by this trust, achieves to knowledge soundness. But I already mentioned that there is a notion stronger than knowledge soundness, simulation knowledge soundness. So I was interested to construct such a snark that can achieve subversion zero knowledge plus simulation knowledge soundness with the same trust. So luckily, I mean, in Shahla's thesis, we presented a new variation of Grot ZK snark. And in that point, for us, it was important to achieve non-malleability in Grot snark. So, but it should be efficient than Grot-Miller that I mentioned. It is published in Crypto 2017. So luckily we managed, and Shahla is going to present it tomorrow. And it is accepted to be presented in SRX workshop in cryptocurrency. So I got interested to achieve subversion zero knowledge in that protocol as well. So why? Because if I could show that prover doesn't need to trust, so basically it is some kind of improvement to other simulation extractable snarks that I mentioned that can guarantee non-malleability of proofs. So, and I did the same procedure, but quite different idea, because here you need to be careful that you don't lose this simulation, but still you keep this zero knowledge. And the idea was different, but basically at the end, I achieved the same, that I didn't even change the CRS for that protocol. Just I proposed the CRS verification and achieved to subversion zero knowledge simulation knowledge sound snark. Basically, the difference is that Grot's snark, our A-Shakir paper doesn't guarantee that the proofs are non-malleable, but this new version guarantees that the proofs are non-malleable, but prover doesn't need to trust to achieve zero knowledge. Yeah, about the second part of presentation, I will talk about this efficiency of privacy-preserving smart contracts by constructing more efficient UC secure ZK snarks. So just a short introduction about a smart contract. You absolutely know better that a smart contract is a computer program that is intended to actually facilitate and verify some rules that you have in this smart contract. And usually parties together, I mean, gather and they they agree on some contract, that this contract is a set of, has some set of rules in your contract, and this set of rules are encoded as a, for example, a circuit, and this is given to the nodes of the network. And at some point, these nodes of the distributed network just verifies that this is correct or not. And usually, I mean, Bitcoin was the first actually system that actually supports such property, that users can do direct transactions without the third party, and at some moment nodes check that some rules, I mean, are held. For example, really this spender knows the secret key for that address, for example. In various applications, I mean, various research, they have shown that they leak the privacy. So to provide privacy of users in that systems, I mean, smart contracts, Hawk is currently the most popular and known system that exactly uses the same idea as other applications. I mentioned that in all these applications, we have an arithmetic circuit that you want to give a proof that I have executed the arithmetic circuit with particular inputs correctly. And to guarantee correctly is by soundness, providing privacy is by zero knowledge. So they do the same. They have a system that gets a program from a developer and converts it to three protocols between users, managers, and blockchain. And if you, I mean, GGS also is a similar system, but for criminal smart contracts. But my focus mostly was in how it was more known. But basically in that system, I mean, I have here an example of smart contracts in Hawk system that users at some point needs to commit. For example, this is for a sealed bit auction. Users need to commit to their values and give a proof that I know that value. This proof is done by SNARKs. And in second, some parts they need to, for example, encode their value to reveal it and then give a proof that, okay, I have encoded the correct, the same value that I have committed. And in some moment, a manager finalizes the protocol and distributes the fund based on the rules. But again, he needs to give a proof. You see that always they need to give a proof. And if you look at this system, they have these three protocols that I am not going to describe the details. But basically, just I wanted to show that in some moment, they need to give a proof or verify the proof. Verification is done on blockchain. So succinctness is very important because you can check very quickly. And this proof generation is done in user and manager side. So prover should be efficient. You should try to make it more efficient. And interestingly, I mean, they have also mentioned that the efficiency of both system, I mean, this Hawk and also GGS in that paper that very shortly I mentioned, the efficiency of whole system is dominated by efficiency of ZK-SNARK. And this is a snapshot from the paper that we focus on evaluating the ZK-SNARK performance, since the all other computations are negligible. So I just, how they constructed this ZK-SNARK? I mean, since their system actually needed to guarantee UC security, so they couldn't use ZK-SNARK directly in their system. Because efficiency of ZK-SNARKs basically is because of these non-falsifiable assumptions, knowledge assumptions that they have used. This is sort of heuristic, and the extraction is black box. But in UC security, we are not allowed to do such extraction. So they actually needed to lift it. Basically, some research, including Gratz in 06 and in 2016, they have shown that if you want to use the ZK-SNARKs in UC secure system, so you need to improve the security of ZK-SNARK. Basically, we already mentioned that by default, ZK-SNARKs guarantee null soundness. So these people, I mean, wanted to achieve, if they wanted to use it in UC secure, so they needed to lift it to achieve black box simulation null soundness. This simulation null soundness, I already mentioned, that guarantees non-malleability of proofs. And this black box guarantees that the extractor can extract the witness from the adversary without getting access to the source code of this adversary. This is a very powerful, actually, requirement. Here is the definition, formal definition, that says that, given a honestly generated setup phase by K, CRS generator, adversary who has access to the Oracle, which returns simulated proofs, so you shouldn't be able to come up with a new proof such that there is an extractor that can extract and verifier accepts. This probability should be negligible. This is quite a strong requirement that it is sufficient for UC security. But this implies slightly weaker notions of soundness. for example, non-black box simulation extractor with your simulation knowledge soundness. Basically, it is, achieves sound simulation knowledge soundness, but based on non-black box extraction. This is very efficient, but still it is not UC secure. And most of ZK snags are, achieve this knowledge soundness that I already mentioned. And soundness is weaker than these others that is implied by stronger ones. So what they, did to achieve this UC secure snark that they needed to their system. So they pick the ZK snark that is used in snark, and they applied, some changes that are proposed by a framework that is called COCO framework to construct a UC secure snark. Note that when you have UC security, you have linear size of proof. Basically, it's not snark, succinct, but still proof is succinct in circuit size, not witness size. So this COCO framework, even a language L for original snark, let's say for Bensasson et al. Snark, so applies these changes, it defines a new language, which is this one is the original language by handing, by encryption of witnesses and by or of the second part, which is basically idea from 89 from Bellard and Goldsware for achieving simulation, this non-malleability in these proofs. And they apply these changes, and based on this new language, they construct a new protocol, which basically uses, as a subroutine, some algorithms of this original, but some extra computations. For example, in setup phase, they add this key generation for public key and commitment for trapdoor and so random. And improver side, they need to generate one-time secure key generation and this part of, computation. And for verifier, they need to add verification of a signature. So I got interested that could we construct the same, achieve the same goal, construct UC secure snark, such that it would be more efficient than the one that they have constructed, because it directly will improve the efficiency of Hawk, for example, or GJS. I asked this question that what if the input NISQ already guarantees more security than soundness that they required, and interestingly, it is more efficient than the one that they have used. We have currently such a scheme. Basically, it is the development of SNARKs that I just had this observation that, now we have more secure, even more efficient SNARK. So why not just simplify this procedure? So I did buy more efficient SNARKs and just simplified this procedure. And I saw that, if we already have ZK SNARKs that guarantees non-malleability of proofs, so we basically don't need that part. So any changes by that part can be removed. I keep the same. So I will use any snark like as Lipman 19 and Graf-Miller. In that moment, I use that one. So we basically, instead of this amount of changes, we will a subset. We will have a small subset of their changes. And we will achieve a UC secure snark with same properties. And here I have implementation of that three snarks. The first one is the snark that they have applied their changes. You see that CRS generation takes 104 seconds and the proof size is this, 287, and so on. And I said that, we have these two snarks, and the second one, my supervisor also proposed one recently, very efficient one. So if we use that one, since we will apply less changes, why? Because already these two protocols guarantee more security than the one that they have used. This allows to achieve better efficiency. So, this was the result that I had in that paper. But very quickly, I will say that what we did in these two papers, because they are in the same direction. So in that case, we saw that some applications using ZK snarks, but they don't talk about the setup phase. Is it UC secure if you generate frequently even? So I asked that, can we have a UC secure? We asked in that protocol that, projects that can we have a UC secure setup phase for such snarks? Basically, we already had snarks that snark itself is UC secure, but setup phase is again using, for example, in the best case, this MPC that was proposed by Bensasson et al. So that MPC guarantees, this property that only one of top n parties needs to be honest and requires but random oracle. So we actually, improved it, and we proposed a new construction that has the same property, but doesn't require a random oracle, and also it guarantees UC security. So basically, we can make whole system UC secure, setup phase and SNAP, that this was. To do so, we proposed a new primitive for UC commitment schemes because we needed particular requirement in that system. And the new commitment scheme is not quite similar to the other ones. In commitment scheme, usually you commit to message and you open to message. But here we commit to message X from ZP, and later we open to G power X in the bilinear group. We needed this property in CRS generation because G power X is your trapdoor for CRS. G power X is the element that you need to give it to prover and verifier, to prove generation and verification. So this was actually the contribution that we had there. And here are some references that I mentioned briefly. If we need, we can discuss about them. Thank you very much.